For your health, you might not know it, but hepatitis C is called a silent killer today, and many people don't know they have it because it could have been in their bodies for decades. There is treatment, though, available for those who are affected, and joining us is Dr. Fernando Membreno with the Methodist Specialty and Transplant Hospital. We're just talking here off camera. This is fascinating to me because people could have it for decades, not have any symptoms, and then you said it's a very effective killer.
Yeah, it's a very fascinating disease because, I mean, it's very silent. You won't feel anything. Some people may have fatigue, but 30 years later, they might develop cirrhosis and liver failure, and they might even need a transplant or just come up with a liver cancer, right, as the first manifestation. And they even didn't feel anything for the last 30 years.
Wow. And what do you tell people about this kind of thing if they're concerned about it? You say baby boomers especially.
Yeah. Now we really want to send this message that the CDC has recommended that everybody who's a baby boomer, so they were born between 1945 and 1965, they should get screened by their primary care physician.
Why baby boomers especially?
Because in that cohort of people is where we see the highest prevalence of hepatitis C. About 3 in 4 patients will have hepatitis C that were born between those years.
And now, is that one of those things where they will eventually, if they live long enough, have the symptoms and could have liver disease?
Yeah, we believe that hepatitis C is a progressive disease. It will take more years for one and more less years for another ones, but they will all progress. And they will progress faster if they have things like alcohol on top or if they develop fatty liver.
But a simple blood test, you say, can check this?
Yes, it's called an antibody for hepatitis C, and any primary care physician can just order it, and it will be done in just a few hours.
Now, this was a big topic back in the 80s and 90s when you said there was interferon that was used, and that can make people sick, but now it's much easier. What do you use to treat people?
So now we are using new pills that essentially are antivirals. They're attacking directly the virus. You take them for about 12 weeks, and over 90% of those patients will be cured without side effects.
And now at Methodist Specialty and Transplant Hospital, do you have a lot of people coming in for this, or what would you tell people there?
Yeah, hepatitis C is the number one cause of liver transplants and liver cancer in the US. So we treat aggressively hepatitis C at the Methodist Specialty and Transplant Hospital, and we want to prevent them from getting to cirrhosis and to needing a transplant. And that's why we want to get to them early before they develop cirrhosis.
Is the blood test the kind of test that your doctor would do automatically? Would they test for that, or do you have to ask them specifically to do that?
At this point, you have to ask them specifically because they're not used to it, right? They're used to check for diabetes, they're used to check for cholesterol, for heart disease, but they're not used to check for hepatitis C. And now the task force, the U.S. task force recommends that they should be checked in the baby boomer age group for hepatitis C at least once in their life.
All right. Well, that's fascinating. Some great information. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Randy,
Fernando Membreno from El Salvador.
Yeah, exactly.
Thanks. Evie?